Good morning. Once again, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Santos Capilian, wishing you a good day. Now, what I'm going to do today is try to explain another operation of a damper actuator. Now, what I have here is a damper actuator for a variable air volume boxes. Okay. Now, this damper actuator, this one is wired to work on a float point control or three position control. When you say float or three-point position control, it is on or open, stop, close. Okay, so there are three position: open, stop, and close. So how it works like that, in that fashion. Okay, now first let me explain how are you going to do the wiring. First you have to provide power supply. Now the power supply for this is 24 volts, as you can see here in the label. It says 24 volts AC. Okay. Now there are three terminals: 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, and 3. Now the details. One is for the counterclockwise rotation. Let's say the counterclockwise rotation is for closing the damper. Then terminal two is for the common of the 24 volts. Then terminal 3 is the clockwise rotation. So meaning we can say that the clockwise rotation is the opening of the damper. Now as you can see, this opening and closing will always depend on the site installation of the damper. Okay, now what I have here is this is the motor, these are the terminals, then this is the damper shaft adapter. So let's say this is the shaft. Then it will be inserted here. Then you can tighten it or secure the damper shaft by setting this set screw. Okay. Now again, the rotation is from 0 to 90 degrees. Okay. Now, how your control program will control this in a three-point position. Now I'm using here two relays. One relay will activate this damper to open, and another relay will activate this damper to close. Okay, so how it will works in a three-point control. Now let's say my control program says you open the valve, the damper actuator at 20%, then it will open at 20%. Then when I have no open control, then it will stop at 20%. Now if again my control program, there is another open control, say I will open it in 30%, then from 20%, it will go to 30%. Then my control program, there is no more open control, then it will stop at 30% opening. Now, if my control program says you will close it at 15%, then this relay will activate this to rotate it the other way. So from 30%, it will go to 15%. If there is no control signal to close it, then it will stay at 15%. So that is open, stop. Then if there is an open control again, then from that current position, it will open to the desired open position. If there is no more open control, then it will stop in that one. So I hope you understand open, stop, and close. So that is the control for float point control or three position control. Okay, so it's very easy to understand, and I do hope I already gave you an idea how a damper actuator works in a three-point control position. Okay, now again, in my previous tutorial, I have shown you how are you going to attach the damper shaft. Then I have given you already an idea how are you going to prevent this damper actuator from burning or from being damaged by making sure that the damper installed in the site can be freely open and can be freely closed manually. And of course, always check the torque requirement of the damper installed in the site before ordering your damper actuator. Okay, so once again, thank you very much for watching my this short video tutorial, and I do hope I have given you an idea how are you going to do it in the near future if you will become a BMS engineer. And don't forget to install the anti-rotation device for the damper actuator. Okay, now this is again Santos Capilian Jr. saying, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe, watch, and make a comment, like, or share my video. And please support my video so I can make more tutorials for new engineers and for engineering graduates who wants to join the field of building management system. Once again, thank you very much. God bless us all. And Santos Capilian Jr. is saying bye for now.